570 miles north of Dutch Harbor. On the Northwestern.
I don't know if I'll send Fahrenheit, but in Celsius, it's negative 30 outside. So it's pretty cold. For normal people, but not for Norwegians. We don't get cold. Our lips just turn blue and then we die.
Oh, Mary Beth, hi, this is Sig Hansen on the Northwestern.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing good here. Okay, so from the 6008 and 176-14, we're still looking at about 20 miles.
To the nearest ice strips or
to the pack? Yeah, to the pack. Okay.
All right, thank you. Have a good day.
So she said we're in a pretty bad spot, right at the point. I don't think we have a lot of time on our hands here. We're talking about a couple of days.
With the Opelio grounds cut in half by the 280,000 square mile Arctic pack.
If that's where the crab are, then that's the game you play. We're not going anywhere.
Captain Sig Hansen charts a course below its projected path, betting he can take advantage of the nutrient-rich ice edge before the floes put a freeze on his gear.
Let's do this. Roger.
Going over.
We're starting to see the steam and mist start coming off the ocean, and that's when you know that the ice pack is close and the ocean's wanting to start freezing.
There is a strip of crab in here, I believe, but it's not very wide. So I'm setting northwest southeast, which is parallel to the ice edge, which is wrong. I should be setting perpendicular so that if it's coming at you at an angle, you want to start at the bottom. Try to get as many pots on board as you can while it's coming down.
Going over.
But right now I'm setting parallel because it's the only way to get them in the water where I think there's crab. So I'm choosing crab over the safety of the pots right now.
Going over.
I hope we're doing the right thing. I don't know. Well, we're on our first string this morning. We'll see how this does. This string goes from 75 fathoms to 71. Covers about 5 miles. We've got a day before that ice edge hits. Hopefully these pots pan out. First pot's up.
I see stuff.
Woo! There we go. Woo! Sweet! So we can just do that steady for 100 pots.
There's some crab coming up in them, so that's all we can ask for right now.
There we go!
Oh my!
Crab! That's gonna work. That's what we're looking for right there.
Looking good.
I want them all like that.
Let's go!
Pew, 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 pew!
Six hundred thirty.
That's good.
That is awesome.
Yeah. We needed that. We're in a dangerous, dangerous area to be fishing in right now. But that's the motivator. That's the kind of fishing we came for. And honestly, I couldn't be happier.
Yeah.
Damn it. This is unexpected. This is not, there's another flow right behind it there too, so. Oh, but we are definitely in harm's way.
Aboard the Northwestern.
That's not what we want to see. I didn't think we'd see this till tomorrow morning sometime. I figured we had time, and we are definitely in harm's way. It's the first stuff that break that comes off before the main pack.
Slicing into Captain Sig's grounds, razor-sharp ice, the advance party of the larger Arctic pack.
That being said, these winds are supposed to switch around northwesterly, and that'll help. So eventually this ice is gonna recede. And so there is another window of time for us. But that's real risky. So in the back of my mind, I'm still thinking, if I lay these back through, are they gonna still be here? That's the negative to a psychopath's mind right there. I don't know, maybe I'll just set him back.
After planting his flag up north.
Yeah, Rog, we'll get it ready.
Captain Sig stands his ground, even when ice flow rumors become ice cold facts.
Every few hours, this game is changing. But if I see crap, I want to put him back. We're throwing the dice. So we've got 60 pots up in this area. Right now, I'm pulling these on short soak. That's because the ice is nearby.
On his hottest Opelio numbers of the season, Captain Sig fishes amongst the floes, getting in one last score before the solid pack ice catches him with his pots down.
Wasn't sure how fast it was moving, so we need to be very careful here. Oh. It's huge. It looks like at least 4 to 6 miles, so we gotta get them on deck. Guys, it's right on the end of the gear. Right on the end of our string, so you gotta go into ice mode. I thought we had till tomorrow morning. That's not what happened. These gotta come on board, okay? All right? It's gonna be a really, really long night.
The 290,000 square mile Arctic pack moves in, forcing Sig to rescue 60 pots in the throes of ice 4 feet thick, strong enough to penetrate the steel of the Northwestern's hull.
I haven't really had to deal with ice packs since I've been here, but I've heard stories and this and that, so hopefully we get all our pots before they get swept away.
Okay, Clark, you guys ready?
Roger.
I don't see the next one in line, so I think we got bit. This thing's moving fast. Ice is just chasing after us now. Next one got moved too.
I think we got bit here.
I can't run. Just gonna have to get the gear on first. Get this, get it done, and then get out of here. Bottom line. They're gonna hate me later. Hate me now, I don't care. I just don't want to lose all my gear.